two alarming robbery investigations happening in communities not usually associated with high crime. 11 News reporter George Lettis is live at City Police Headquarters. He has details for us. George?
Well, Rod, we're talking about home invasions and stick-ups at bus stops. In both investigations, police are offering a reward of up to $2,000 for information that leads to an arrest and an indictment. Baltimore City Police are intensifying efforts to solve a series of armed robberies and home invasions in two North Baltimore neighborhoods, Homeland and Waverly, that don't normally experience a ton of crime. In the Homeland neighborhood, police say a man has robbed a handful of residents in the Villages of Homeland section by gun and knife point. Several times, police say the man has forced his way into homes while the victims are inside to rob them of cash.
That is obviously nothing that you ever want to experience, and it's nothing that we've ever heard about before.
The last incident was Thursday when the suspect was waiting on a woman's second floor balcony and forced his way in when she opened the door.
Yes, it's very concerning, and I encourage everybody who lives in our neighborhood and in the Villages of Homeland to watch out and be careful of your surroundings. Look around before you get in your house. Make sure no one's following you.
A few miles south in Waverly, police are investigating several reports of a man robbing people at bus stops.
He's brandishing a handgun, and he's snatching women's purses. He's actually targeting women getting on or off the bus.
I try not to be by myself. Like, I don't like catching the bus by myself at night. And, yeah, you just shouldn't.
Police are working with MTA police to see if surveillance cameras on the buses caught any of these incidents on tape. Now, in the Homeland cases, victims say the suspect is 5'7 to 5 feet 8 inches tall, a thick build wearing dark clothing and a dark ski mask. Now, in the Waverly cases, the suspect is 5'5 to 5 feet 6 inches tall, average build wearing dark clothing, a dark ski mask, and sometimes a camouflage jacket. Now, at this point, detectives cannot say if any or all of these cases are connected. We're live at police headquarters. George Lettis, WBAL-TV 11 News.